السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم migrated to Medina, one of the first advice and instructions that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم had given to the Muslims was يا أيها الناس أفشوا السلام وأطعموا الطعام وصلوا الأرحام وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام تدخلوا الجنة بسلام. The advice that was given by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, that he said, O people, أفشوا السلام, spread peace amongst yourselves, and feed the people who are in need, and also offer food to other people. أطعموا الطعام. And keep the good and the kind relationship between you and your relatives. وصلوا الأرحام. And pray in the night time while other people are asleep. صلوا بالليل والناس نيام. You will enter Jannah in peace. So one of these commands or one of these teachings that was given by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is صلوا الأرحام, الصلة. And whenever we talk about the subject, we always say, keep the good and the kind relationship between you and your relatives. Do this for them. Never ever cut the ties between you and them. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء. واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام. O mankind, fear Allah, your Lord, who created you from a single person, and from him created his mate, and from both of them spread many men and women. Fear Allah, through whom you demand your mutual rights, and you ask one another. Fear Allah, and never ever cut the ties and the relationship between you and your relatives. Fear Allah, and know that Allah is watching and observing each and every one of us. Many ayat of the Quran that talk about this subject. We're not talking about the subject of keeping the connection or the kind and the good relationship between the Muslim and his relatives in detail. But we are talking about one specific thing. And that specific is, or one specific item is, if there is a problem between the person and his relatives, what are the minimum things that he has to keep regardless of the problem? So basically, we're talking about the least that the Muslim cannot waive. Any things that the Muslim cannot waive with regard to the relationship between him and his relatives, even though there is a problem between him and them. So that means that there is a minimum over there. There's of course a maximum, and there are other details and other rights, but there are minimum things. What are these minimum things that the Muslim has to keep in his relationship with his relatives, even though there is a problem between him and them? There are four things that the Muslim has to keep in regard or with regard to the relationship between him and his relatives, and he cannot waive them by any means. The first one is to keep the connection with them, to keep the communication with them, regardless, even at least calling, talking, what saying the salam, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in his hadith. He said, "Silu arhamakum walau bis-salam." Silu arhamakum walau bis-salam. He said, keep the relationship between you and your relatives, even with the salam. يعني even if the only thing that you are going to say to your uncle, to your cousin, to your brother, to your sister, to the one that is from the arham, even if it is only the salam, this is the minimum that you can keep. So we cannot even waive this one. So the first thing that we have to keep regardless is what? The salam, even the salam. To keep the connection between us and them, according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, صِلُوا أَرْحَامَكُمْ وَلَوْ بِالسَّلَامِ. Keep the connection between you and your relatives even with the salam. This is the first one. The first minimum requirement. The second minimum requirement that we need to keep with regard to them is to to protect them from our harms, not to harm them by any means. If we are in a situation, if I'm in a situation that I'm going to do something and it is going to harm any one of my relatives, his right upon me, even if there is a problem between me and him, his right upon me or her right upon me is that I will never and I should never harm them by any means. The Muslim is supposed to restrain his harms from other people. How about his relatives? And what the Prophet ﷺ said in his hadith, Al-Muslimu, man salima al-Muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadihi. The true Muslim is the one from the harm of his hand and his tongue. Other people, other Muslims are safe. If we're talking about Muslims in general, we're talking about the people in general that we're not supposed to harm them. How about our relatives? So this is the second minimum requirement with regard to our relationship with our relatives. Number three, the third minimum requirement that we have to keep with our relatives, regardless, again I'm saying regardless of what's happening between us, is if one of them is in need of help, we have to help him. Even if that person is my enemy, if any one of them is in need of help, then we have to help him. And I mean by help, financial help or any other kind of assistance that the person is in need, then we have to help this person. A Muslim is required to help the other people who are in need. How about when it comes to his relatives? So he cannot come at this time and say, I have a problem with this person. I have a problem with my brother. I have a problem with my sister. I have a problem with my cousin, with my uncle, and I'm not going to help them by any means. That's not acceptable in Islam. This is the third minimum requirement that we have to keep with them. The fourth one, which is the last one, is to make istighfar for them or to make dua for them. The Muslim is making dua for all the Muslims. How about the relatives? هذا أبو ذر رضي الله تعالى عنه. Abu Dharr, one of the great companions of the Prophet ﷺ, we knew him and we knew his status. And things happened between the relatives. جاء إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. He came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وقال يا رسول الله يكون بيني وبين القرابة ما يكون بين الرجل وقرابته. يعني there's something that sometimes happened between me and my relatives similar to anyone, to any other person who has a problem with his relatives. What should I do? سيد يكون بيني وبين قرابتي ما يكون بين الرجل وقرابته. Sometimes a problem happens between me and my relatives like any other person. What should I do in this situation? اسمع ماذا قال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأين أنت من الاستغفار لهم. Where are you from making استغفار for them? يعني the minimum that you can do for them even if there is a problem between you and them is to what? Is to make istighfar for them. Is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their forgiveness. So my dear brothers and sisters, I want you to keep these four minimum requirements. We're not talking about the maximum ones. This is a completely different subject. But at least the minimum things that we have to keep between us and our relatives is number one, to keep the connection between us and them, even with the salam. Number two, to restrain our harms from them, not to harm them by any means. Number three, if any one of them is in need of help, financial or otherwise, then we have to help them. And number four, at least to make dua for them or to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their forgiveness. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فاتبعون أحسنه أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى ومن العمل ما ترضى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا واشرح صدورنا وبلغنا مما يرضيك آمالنا وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. جزاكم الله خير.